Live bands in the world, but the last time they set out on a 30-date UK tour was back in 1979. Jim, is that true?
A wee while ago, yes.
My word.
Yeah, and here we are, about to do it again. Still, well, in March we're doing it.
Still going strong?
I think so, yeah. Still loving it, still getting great, great audiences, and we have to assume that we're sort of, this is what we're born to do, you know. If you had said to us, when we started the band in 1977, you know, what do you want to do? What do you want to get out of this? We would have said that we want to be a great live band and we want to take it around the world. And every night we still try and get on with that challenge.
Well, you've got the, you know, in our introduction to you, one of the greatest live bands around.
Yeah, my mum said that.
Everyone's just
adopted it.
It's a big name to live up to. What kind of makes...
It is.
What do you think makes you guys so good live on stage compared to others?
Well, it wouldn't be right for me to say
that. Oh, go on, try.
Well, we give 100% every night, I think, and we don't, you know, on a world tour, we can be plenty of anything from 2,000 people to 50,000 people, but we would attack it with the same relish.
I know you're being modest, but you decide. Let's see the band in action.
Jim, if we need reminding, that's one of the great sing-along moments in concerts, isn't it? When you don't have to know the words, you can just go with it.
The words aren't very difficult, that's right.
Is it just la-la-la-la?
It seems to be, yeah. I think a lot of the great pop songs had very...
But is it, it's like an, that song particularly, it's like a kind of an anthem song, isn't it?
Yeah, I think there was a period in our career where as we moved into the bigger venues and we're getting bigger crowds, I don't know why, but it seemed that the music went along with that and that the songs seemed to fit. And I think it's always great to have a few songs where, because to go and watch a band is one thing, but to go and join in with them, I think, is for a few songs.
Do you ever mind? We spoke to David Essex earlier about singing the old songs and the crowd, the audience demanding almost the old favourites. Do you ever mind?
No, I think if you're lucky enough to have a catalogue that people want to hear, and I think what we do is we various tours, we focus on different parts. Earlier this year we did a series of shows that was essentially a non-greatest hits. We did a lot of songs from our early albums before we had the breakthrough, and that obviously appealed to the hardcore. The tour that we're doing next March, which goes on sale today at 10 o'clock, it's the middle period and all those big, big songs. But we're always writing.
So you've got new hits going on in the Greatest Hits tour, so to speak.
Next week we're back in the studio recording again, and that kind of keeps it fresh. That freshens everything up.
So is the music a full... I mean, you say you've been working constantly all this time. There's a horrible sense. People say, oh, whatever happened to Jim Kerr? What have you been doing all this time? Have you had another life outside of the music? I mean, do you do other things? You live in the UK? Do you have a hotel? Is that right?
Yes, that's right. I spend a lot of time in Italy and in France. And quite a lot of people know that I have a hotel. And in Sicily, I'm very, very lucky to have come across this great part of the world, and I'm really passionate about Italy and especially the south. And
so do you work behind the...
Are you hands on?
Behind the desk? Do you check people in?
Basil Fawlty kind of way?
No, thank God. I mean, we've got a great team there who run the place. And it lets me... When actually well, we built the place as well. I'm from a family of builders. Probably 10, 12 years ago, I thought there was about a year where I thought maybe the music is ending. We weren't really doing so much. But ironically, since we opened the doors, I've been on tour and I hardly ever get there.
What do you think sparked the revival, the interest?
Revival interest. I think going back to this thing about being a good live band, if you are a good live band, and if you've got a few songs that people grew up with, wherever we go in the world, it seems to be there's an audience that want to hear that. And between things like classic radio and all that stuff that focus on the era of music that we're from and before us.
Do you get that thing, Jim, where lots of people say, oh, when I heard that song, it was when me and my husband, or... I bet you have that quite a bit, don't you?
We do, yeah. And it's, you've got different fans. You've got fans that will get absolutely everything, and then you've got the taxi driver who goes, hang on a minute, you're the guy in Simply Red. And I go, no. And they go, oh, yeah, that's right, yeah.
Well, I'll tell you what, looking at your hairstyle here, though, it was...
I'm too scared.
It's a bit floppy.
It's been a while since it flopped.
You're really not looking at the screen now. We better take that image
off
now, because Jim's not keen on looking at that.
Yeah.
Is that not comfortable, watching that back? Does it feel a bit weird?
For my kids, definitely.
Funny.
I think... listen, it'd be weird if you did enjoy looking at yourself.
That
would be even weirder, I think.
Yes, very true. Well, Jim, a lot of people would be very pleased to know you're back on tour.
We are absolutely delighted.
Tickets go on sale 10 o'clock.
Tickets are on sale from our website just now, but they go on sale everywhere else from 10 o'clock, I've been told to say.
Lovely to see you here today.
Lovely seeing
you. Thank you very much.
Simple Minds Greatest Hits tour next spring, and go on sale, as Jim was just saying. This.